Hey everyone, I was asked if I could make a video on Ubuntu 24.04 and the qFlipper 0. I've spent the last 30 years doing mostly Windows development, so leave a comment below if you know the right way to do things. In this video, we'll set up qFlipper so that our qFlipper can talk to our operating system, and we'll set up Visual Studio Code so that we can build our own qFlipper 0 applications. Let's get started. The first app we'll install is called qFlipper. So go over to your terminal, and then in your terminal, go ahead and type sudo space apt space install space qFlipper. Type in the password for your account, and then say yes to continue. This will end up installing qFlipper as an application, and it will also install the rules so that the qFlipper application can access the USB without needing to run as root. So after it's installed, in your bin folder, you'll find the qFlipper and qFlipper CLI commands. Notice the capital F on qFlipper. And you'll also now have it installed here, so you can easily just choose qFlipper. Many people in the forums recommend using the cable that came with your qFlipper 0. The qFlipper app will mirror what's on your qFlipper screen. And in the Files tab, we can also manipulate what's on the SD card. Once you have qFlipper installed and working with your qFlipper 0, I recommend clicking Install and then the Update button. This will update the firmware on your qFlipper 0 to the latest release version. After a couple of minutes, you should get a success message. And on your qFlipper 0, you should see Firmware Update Success. The qFlipper 0 firmware uses GitHub for source control, so we're going to do a sudo space apt space install space git, and then type in your password and say yes to continue. This installs the Git tools for both command line and Visual Studio Code. Next, we'll install Visual Studio Code. Type sudo space snap space install space dash dash classic space code. This will install the Visual Studio Code editor, which we can use to edit our firmware. Next, I'll follow the steps in my wiki to clone and build our firmware. Type mkdir space repo and then cd repo. You can use any folder you'd like to store your repository. In this video, I'm using official firmware, but you can use whichever firmware you'd like as well. Git space clone space dash dash recursive space and the URL to the, in some examples I also specify an output directory to clone into. I always use the dash dash recursive option when cloning firmware since it has submodules, but I believe the fbt command may also pull down the submodules. Once the firmware is cloned, do cd space and the name of the qFlipper folder. And firmware sometimes have different branches, such as release, dev, or release candidate. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and check out the release branch. So we'll do get space checkout space release. Next, we'll install Visual Studio Code support. So type dot slash fbt space vs code underscore dist. This will install the files for Visual Studio Code. And it'll install options under terminal run task and also for the debugger. Next, we'll build and deploy the firmware to our qFlipper. So dot slash fbt space compact equals one space debug equals zero space force equals one space flash underscore USB underscore full. Make sure your qFlipper is plugged in and that qFlipper is not running. This takes several minutes, so I'll go ahead and cut to the end. The files will get transferred to your qFlipper 0. And those files are in the dist folder underneath the F7-C. And you can see there's that TGZ file if you want to install directly as a file. After a few more minutes, you should see qFlipper update success. And at this point, your qFlipper 0 is now running the firmware that you installed and built locally. Next, we'll open Visual Studio Code. From the main menu, choose File, and then Open Folder. Our firmware was stored under Home, and then Repo, and then Flipper Zero Firmware. Go ahead and say Open, and then choose Yes, I Trust the Authors. You should get a pop-up about installing recommended extensions. Go ahead and say Install. Over in our File Explorer, there's a folder called .vscode, and if you expand that, you'll see an extensions.json file. This lists the unwanted recommendations, which are mostly CMake tools that should be disabled in your project. So go ahead and search for CMake, and if any of these already are installed, go ahead and click Disable for my workspace. And if it has an install button, then there's nothing you need to do further. Next, let's go ahead and build and deploy our firmware. So go to Terminal, and then go to Run Task. And if you've disabled those CMake extensions, then you should get a menu that pops up with all the Flipper Zero options. And then choose Flash USB with Resources. You can see it's running FBT with that Flash underscore USB underscore full option. This means once it's done building the firmware, it'll copy it to the Flipper using the USB. You'll notice that the menu had a bunch of debug in square brackets or release in square brackets. For application development, I recommend using the square bracket debug versions. This will take a couple minutes while it builds the firmware, and then once it's done building, it'll deploy it to the Flipper. And then once it's on the Flipper, it'll take a few minutes to install. Now that everything's installed, let's go ahead and go into Applications, Main, Bad USB app.c. The file's not really important. What I want to show is that we can go into the definition and declaration of different methods. So I'll go ahead and right-click on Flipper Format File Alloc, and I'll say Go to Definition. And we can see the header file that explains that method. If we right-click on that and say go to declaration instead, it'll jump us into the implementation file, and we can actually see the code for that method as well. This technique is super helpful for reading the comments for methods as well as looking at their implementation. Next, let's add a custom application to our firmware. I'm going to clone my Flipper Zero tutorial, so click on the code button and then copy the GitHub URL. Over in our command window, do a cd repo and then go git space clone space and then paste in that GitHub URL. Cloning a different project is basically the same steps. Once that's done, we'll go into the directory that we just created, which is Flipper Zero Tutorials. And for this example, we'll cd into the sub-gigahertz folder, and then into the apps folder, and then into the Genie Recorder application. You'll notice that this folder has the application.fam file that's needed for the application to run. We'll go ahead and cd back to our repo folder, and then we'll go into our Flipper Zero firmware folder. Underneath that is applications underscore user. This is where we put all of our custom applications. For a symbolic link, we'll do ln space dash s space, and then we'll copy the path to that Genie Recorder app and paste it in. This will end up creating a Genie Recorder that's a symbolic link into our Genie Recorder app. This means that changes we make in Visual Studio Code will also get reflected in the repo that we cloned. If I cd into that Genie Recorder and do a ls, you can see there's application.fam. Back in Visual Studio Code, under applications underscore user, there's now a Genie Recorder. And when we go into that, we can see our application.fam file. Next, choose Terminal, and then Run Task. And then this time do debug launch app on Flipper. Make sure your Flipper's plugged in and that qFlipper's not running. And then once it's done, I'll open qFlipper, and we can see the custom application is now installed. Now you know how to install custom firmware and applications. Please like and subscribe, and leave a comment below with any corrections.